Growing numbers of people all over mid-America are having the utilities shut off. At the same time, the electric company has legislation in place in Jefferson City to make it easier for them to get rate hikes. What in the world's going on? Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. In Jefferson City, there's legislation to make it easier for the electric company to get a rate hike so they don't have to wait for a long period of time before the Board of Public Service Commission. So what in the world is going on? So many people are having the utilities shut off. I understand your husband is disabled?
Yes.
And your electric is off?
Yes, they shut it off yesterday.
Tell us your name.
Lisa Harmon.
And who is this?
Katie Harmon.
Hi, Katie.
Hi.
Lisa.
Hi.
What's is shut off yesterday? What kind of impact that have on you?
A lot. Food-wise, coldness, things like that.
And how much do you have to give it back on?
$1,000.
Wow. Well, we don't have those kind of resources right now, but we're going to try to help you with some.
Okay.
And how did you end up coming here?
I watched your show.
Right. And so it was good that you were watching.
Yeah.
You got to keep on praying, too.
Yeah.
We don't receive any city, state, or federal dollars or United Way dollars. And we have so many hurting people that come. You're talking about your food, your destroyed food in your freezer or refrigerator?
Both. And our water, it don't work with the electric ain't on, so things like that.
Seems like it's putting a tremendous amount of stress on you.
It is.
You said your husband is disabled?
Yes.
I want to ask you all to keep him in prayer. Tell him your first name again.
Lisa.
Katie.
Lisa, Katie, their family. And where are you all from?
Richwoods, Missouri.
And that's down in Washington County?
Yes.
And there isn't a whole lot of help down there?
No, there isn't.
A lot of people in need down there, too, isn't it?
Yes, there is.
We have our center in Potosi, Missouri. We have so many people coming to the free store, and so many people coming in day after day for a shelter, and people that are hurting. And the need is just really great right now down there, and there's a lot of people in need. We think of the needs just being in the big city, but they're not. There are many, many people facing needs at this time, isn't there?
Yes.
Do you know that God is right there with you, that He loves you?
Yes.
I know when you're going through all the pressures, it's easy to say, God, where are you?
Yeah.
That's why I have to read the Psalms. I have to read the Bible. That knowledge grow in me, so I hang on, because it's easy to give up.
At times, yeah.
It's really easy to give up, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So I see you have your 19-year-old daughter here to help you, though.
Yeah. Yeah, she's been a lot of help.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How, in what way is she helping your mom?
Mainly just being there for me, and when she sees I'm giving up on things, like she found your number and things like that.
Yeah.
And I thank God for those of you that are sharing at this time, and please keep this family in your prayers. They're not alone. There are so many, many people that are hurting at this time. We not only find them throughout the greater St. Louis bi-state area, we also find them in Springfield, Missouri, where they come to our outreach center in Springfield at 806 North Jefferson. There are so many people hurting it now, and they need help. And New Life Evangelistic Center is working to be there when people are hurting, but we need you to pray for us right now. Just pray for a spring miracle for the New Life Evangelistic Center. With God, all things are possible. And I'm asking you to pray for us at this moment. And let's believe God for that miracle that's needed. And yes, continue to pray as New Life continues to reach out all over mid-America.
My name is Julia Hutton. I've been homeless for over a year now. I come to the Veterans Center to use the computers, grab something to eat. They have hygiene items, clothing. It helps out when you have nothing, when there's not many places in the community that you can go. The people are nice up here. They're respectful. They treat you like your family. I appreciate the Veterans Center. I'm so thankful that the vets have opened up this place for not only the vets, but the community. I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
I thank God for those of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Yes, in Springfield, Missouri, 806 North Jefferson, the largest walk-in shelter in mid-America. Homeless people continue to come in there on a daily basis. They receive their meals. They have lockers. They got computers. They got a place to nap. They got a free store, like a shower, laundry, all of that. So that's in Springfield. But in here in the greater St. Louis area, the bi-state area, so many people are having their electric shut off at this time, and they're about to shut off your electric. What is your name?
Yes, they're about to cut off my electric. My name is Shalexis John.
And who is this?
She's Chloe. Her name is Chloe.
Hi, Chloe.
Hi.
Jesus said, let the little children come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. And yes, he's truly the light of the world. He's come to set the captives free. And so many people right now feel like they're slaves to the big utility companies. They just keep raising the rates all the time, don't they?
Yes, yes.
Just keep on raising those rates.
Just keep on raising.
And they're about to shut you off. Is that right?
Yes, that's correct.
And if you get shut off, how's that going to impact you and the little one?
Not very well. We'll have to move in with someone and, you know.
We got to try to help keep it on. And how did you end up coming here?
We caught the bus.
Uh-huh. And somebody told you about this place?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Urban League.
Urban League. They directed you over here. So, yes, so we have referrals from many other agencies. The New Life Evangelistic Center does not receive any city, state, or federal dollars, nor United Way dollars. It's the caring people that are getting directly involved. This is a grassroots organization. You say, why don't you receive funds from those entities? Because if we did, they'd be telling us we couldn't be sheltering the homeless people here, and they'd cut off our funds anyway. So we've got to help people that are hurting, people that are homeless, people's utilities are shut off. And there's a lot of them that are in need, a lot of them in need, just like this lady and her little one, right?
Yes, that's correct.
And we're asking you to please help us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Just let God's light and love flow through you at this moment as we desire just to be there when people are hurting. And there's so many people that are hurting, and they continue to come day after day to New Life Evangelistic Center. So I'm asking you to please pray for us and share that much-needed tax-deductible gift now at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. And just let the light and love of Jesus flow in you and through you. In addition to showing you this need here in the bi-state area, we're continuing to show you the needs of people that come to us in the Springfield, Missouri area that continue to come to our doors day after day, week after week, with nowhere to go during the days. And so please continue to pray for that facility. We praise God for those that have been getting directly involved. We still need $7,000 to get that roof fixed. Just be praying for that as we're desiring to help individuals to keep their lights on. Wow, if they cut off your lights, it'd be hard on her. The refrigerator wouldn't work, light wouldn't work, electric wouldn't work.
Yeah.
How old are you?
She's one. How old are you?
1 year old. That's fantastic. Let's not leave the little children in the dark, nor out on the streets. Please help New Life Evangelistic Center.
My name is Terry Castile. I've been homeless for about a year now, and I'm thankful for the VA center here because it gives us a place to get out of the elements. We have food, snacks. They give us lunch, a place to wash our clothes, take a shower. The bus passes are great because if we have to go for a job interview or run across town to take care of some personal business, they're there for us, and we sure appreciate everything they do for us. Thank you.
Come to New Life Evangelistic Center. This man's on disability, and his lights have just been shut off. Now, tell us your name.
My name is Rodney Dunn.
Okay, Rodney, you're on disability, and your electric was just shut off yesterday. Yes. What happened when it got shut off? What kind of impact have on you?
Well, I lost my meat and my stuff in the refrigerator.
Lost your meat?
Yeah.
And stuff in the refrigerator?
Yeah, my other food is in the refrigerator.
Wow. This must have been quite traumatic for you.
Yes, it was.
How did you end up coming to the New Life Evangelistic Center?
I called UE, and they gave me your number.
Okay, well, all we receive from them is bills, okay? So Ameren Union Electric, they'll send the people down here, but they sure do not send any money to help. They just keep raising the people's bills, it seems like, on and on and on. It seems like they keep raising the bills, and then they give donations to these senators and representatives and Jefferson City, and they vote the way they want them to vote. I mean, people are just kind of caught in this vicious cycle.
Right.
We have a man at the desk out there. You need to talk to him about getting some compact fluorescent light bulbs, okay?
Yes, sir.
And about the whole world of renewable energy.
Right.
So we need to start thinking about how can we begin to transfer over that world of renewable energy? How can we start using solar power more? How can we cut back on our electric bill? How much is your bill right now?
$240.
$240, and you don't have that kind of money?
Not at the moment.
All right, $240. They're cutting off his, it has been cut off, right?
It's cut off, yeah, yesterday.
And you're not alone. There seems to be a lot of people who are cut off right now, don't they?
Yep.
A lot of people who are totally shut off at this moment. And we just need a miracle down here at New Life Evangelistic Center as we're trying to help people that are in need. And I just thank God for those of you that have really been praying for us down here. I'm just believing God for a miracle where we're just going to see him do exceedingly beyond what we can ask or think, and we'll be able to help all these people. There are people that are hurting right now, big time. And, you know, it seems like the other agencies say they don't have money. We don't receive any United Way funding, no city, state, or federal dollars. Ameren UE never sends anything. So what we got to do is we've got to just ask you to pray, and we have to look to God on a day-by-day basis. Are you looking to Him?
Yes, sir.
Do you pray?
Yes, I do.
Do you really?
Yes, sir, I really do.
How does it give you strength? You said you're disabled. Well, you've been through a lot in the past.
Right.
How has it sustained you? Prayer, reading the Bible, staying close to Jesus.
Well, it make me able to get up every day, you know, and I'm...
If Jesus hadn't risen from the dead, and if he had helped you after all you've been through over the past few years, would you just caved in, maybe give it up? You think you'd have given up?
Well, I have caved in before, but right now I'm lifted up right now.
Right now the Holy Spirit's working in you,
yes,
and looking to the Lord and asking for His help right now.
Yes.
Well, we want everybody to keep praying for you, okay?
I appreciate it. I need it.
We all need it. We all need it.
Yeah.
But God is able, isn't He?
Yes, He is.
God is good.
God is good.
We can't lose hope. This man's in the dark right now, and if he can declare that type of testimony, what about you that have your lights on right now? What are you distressed about? What are you depressed about? Come on, wake up. Look alive. Why art thou cast down, O my soul, as the psalmist would say to himself? Let us rise up at this time. Go out. Look at the great outdoors that God has created. Look at the plants starting to come out. Look at things starting to turn green right now. Look at the resurrection we see all around us.
Right.
And so let Christ be resurrected in your life and heart right now. And just watch Him do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think. Yes, this is a holistic program here at New Life Evangelistic Center. We're sharing with people that there's hope. Christ is risen. And we want you to know that also. And it's not just something we celebrate on Easter. It's year-round. So if you've never committed your life to Jesus, do it now. As many as call on the name of the Lord, they shall be called the children of God. Just bow your head and say, Lord, I ask you to forgive me for all my sins. Lord, forgive me for drifting away from you. Lord, help me to trust you, to be led by you. Lord, to receive you at this hour. And Lord, show me what you want me to do with the rest of my life as I desire to serve you in word and deed. Help me, Jesus. There are so many opportunities awaiting at New Life Evangelistic Center. Amen. In addition to bringing you the needs of people's utility shut off, we continue to remind you of those that are hurting, those that are homeless, those who come to us night after night, week after week. Please continue to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center, and please let the light and love of Jesus flow through you. I mentioned our day center, our reception center in Springfield, Missouri. So many homeless people coming to us there. It means a lot to so many, and that's why I'm asking you to please help us at New Life Evangelistic Center. We're still having to raise $7,000 to help them with their roof there as we're trying to help people whose utilities are shut off. Please share that much-needed gift now with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Yes, the homeless keep coming to us day after day, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri, as well as all night long at 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis. And as we are battling in those communities to do even more for the homeless, yes, to do all-night services in Springfield, to maintain all-night services here in St. Louis, we come to you and say, please pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Because while we're doing that, we still have so many people that are coming that need help on their energy assistance. That seem like the weather's warmed up now, and Ameren UE is just shutting anybody and everybody off, aren't they?
Yes.
And they just shut you off.
Yes, last week.
Okay, what kind of problems does this present for you?
Well, I have a 5-year-old and a 2-year-old in the house, you know, and I have to keep the electric on. So, and right now I'm not working, so... It's a big problem, you know, because you have babies in the home, you know, and the 5-year-old, she goes to school, so, you know, and yes, it's rough.
Did you try explaining this to Ameren UE?
I've done it before, you know, but they, you know, really not concerned about, you know, your problems at home, so, you know.
They just shut you off.
Just shut you off, yeah.
Wow,
yeah.
So what are the little ones saying? Everything's dark.
Yeah. The 5-year-old, she would say, "It's dark. It's dark. Granny can't see." You know, like that. And, you know, I say it's going to be okay.
So these are your grandchildren. You're helping her.
Yeah, my grandchildren. I'm helping my daughter with her kids. You know. Yeah.
A lot of grandmas are doing that right now, having to help raise the grandkids.
Yeah. You know.
So
I mean, I like to keep my family together, you know.
So how did you said they can't see, the little ones say they can't. So what do? How do you help them to see at night?
Well, candles, you know.
It's dangerous. You can burn the house.
It's dangerous, yeah. Yeah, candles, and it's as best I can do, you know, right now.
Well, there's a lot of people hurting right now, isn't there?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. You know, all over the world, yes. You know, yes. Mm-hmm. A lot of homeless, you know.
A lot of them. We see them coming here. Life evangelistic center.
Yes.
So how did you end up coming to this place?
Well, you know, I've seen you on TV, you know, and I've been calling around for help, so, you know.
Well, we're going to try to help you with what we can. Our funds are extremely limited at this time, and the people are really hurting out there.
Yes.
I mean, it's just like there's a wave after wave of shutoff, and Amber and UE trying to push legislation through so they can bypass, to a big extent, the Public Service Commission so they don't have to wait for rate increases, and every year, another one, another one, another one, it seems like. It just keeps going up and up and up.
Up and up and up, you're right. And it's sad, you know. There's a lot of people, you know, trying out here, but...
And that's why we continue to explore and pray, Lord. How can we help people move over to solar power and wind power and discover energy independence? You can go to our website, moreenergy.org. We're talking about compact bulbs. Meantime, as they make this transition, they need help on their utility bill, and we're trying to help them, and we can't do it without all of you. And the number is 436-2424. 1-800-334-3276. If you'd just like to share, or let us know that you're praying for us right now. We need you to just be praying for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And we thank God for those that are caring and sharing, don't we?
Yes, I appreciate it. I really do, you know.
And it's not only the people whose utilities shut off. There's so many are homeless.
Yes,
and they just keep coming, both by night and by day. So many coming, and they're coming not only to us at 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis, but also 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. I thank God for those of you that are getting involved right now.
Hi, I'm Michael Mansker. I have been homeless for 1 year. I come to the Veterans Center for help and assistance on hygiene items and clothing. They have been very good to me and very helpful. I think they're very good, positive for the community, and they are helping me with the bus tickets for me to get back and forth to find work, and I thank them very much. Thank you.
When people come to the New Life Evangelistic Center, not only do we directly try to help them as the Lord provides for our energy assistance, but we also give them compact fluorescent light bulbs. We praise God for those that are sharing right now. And we have these compact fluorescent light bulbs that we're giving you all right now. Look at this, all the power that you all are going to get by using this bulb, and it's going to save you all this money. Do you realize that, folks? All the money you're going to save by using these bulbs rather than an incandescent light bulb. So be sure you put these in now and save some money on those, okay? And these individuals are not alone. There are so many people right now that need to, if you haven't switched over to these compact fluorescent light bulbs, every one of these bulbs are going to save you $45. That means $90 you're going to save on your electric bill just by using these light bulbs. All of them. And you need to get these too. The price keeps going down on these. So if you got any of those old incandescent light bulbs, get rid of them and use these light bulbs. And we've been sharing with people that are having trouble paying the utility bills right now. And I just thank God for those of you that are getting directly involved. David, come on over here a minute. I'm going to talk to David. David's with Missouri Renewable Energy. It's one of the things that we do here. These little 15-watt bulbs give them 60 watts of power. We share that with them. We do now have our energy offices open at Overland. You want to give them the address?
It's 2448 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. And I'm there twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 10 to 4. Come by, speak to me if you have any saving on your heating and cooling.
You've got a whole room dedicated to that. You can
Absolutely.
Show them that. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, keep some of these bulbs on hand. If they drop by, you can give them some bulbs.
Absolutely. I have plenty of them there. The library will be open at those hours also.
All right. And again, this is every Tuesday and Thursday. We have our energy offices open now in Overland, Missouri. And give them that address again.
2448 Overland, Missouri, Woodson Road.
And if you have questions, call us at 421-3020. And again, if you drop by and visit David, he'll give you a couple of these light bulbs,
Absolutely.
Right?
And if you need to reach me personally, my office number is 314-881-3213.
Okay, this is one more service of the New Life Evangelistic Center, as we're reaching out to be there when people are hurting, whether it's people's utilities are shut off, are about to be shut off, or they want to save money energy bill. We also encourage you to go to www.moreenergy.org, find out about our energy shows.
Absolutely.
Coming up. Remember, Tuesdays and Thursdays, he's over there. Drop by and visit him and ask for a couple of free light bulbs. And pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Let's go back to Springfield.
I'm Markham Lee Smith, and here at the VA, we get food and clothing and help here, and place to stay warm. And I'm trying to get a bus pass because I'm legally blind for public transportation, get around to find me a place to rent on the first of the month. And this man's helping me out.
She was homeless a couple of months, and you got some help here?
Yes, I did.
What kind of help did you get?
I got help for my medicine. Yeah, it took time for me to have a place to stay when I was getting ready to, I was waiting on my appointment to get ready, and you really did help me out. Yes, you did.
So we thank God for those donating to New Life so we can help you, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
A lot of people in need right now, aren't they?
Yes, sir.
So now you're in your own place.
Yes, sir. And then you did a weatherize for me, too.
Uh-huh,
and so now I'm looking for utility assistance.
Oh, okay. And so you come to New Life here, and so the people here have been helping you a lot. They came out to your home to help you weatherize your house?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And I really appreciated you.
Up in your windows and the light?
Yes, sir.
Well, we thank God for all of you that are helping here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Yes, we try to get them off the street. We continue to minister to them. And we want you to know we can only do this because of Jesus. He's done so much.
Yes, yes. You've been good. And Jesus is good to me, too.
Oh, yes. Christ is the one. He's the reason we're able to help right now.
Yes, sir.
And we thank God for those that are helping at this time so we can help those in need. And it's New Life of Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. I'm asking you to please pray for us and share. Yes, you can share that special gift now that's so urgently needed at New Life Evangelistic Center. We have so many people that are coming with so many different needs, and each one of you that are calling, your gift is making such a big difference. Each one of you that are sharing, I just want to say thank you. Give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org, helping to break the cycle of homelessness for people and standing with them, and always letting them know that Christ is risen, right?
Christ is good, yes. And you were so good to me. I just praise God. I tell everybody, if it weren't for Reverend Rice, I would have been still walking in the streets.
All I am is a simple man that's trying to do the work of Jesus.
Yes, you are.
And I thank God for those of you that have helped make it possible, for we can let our light shine and help so many who are in need at this hour.
Yes, God bless you.
So many people come to the New Life Evangelistic Center day after day, week after week. They have so many different needs, not only in St. Louis and Springfield, but Potosi and Van Buren and Columbia. I mean, I can just mention place after place, Marshfield, Joplin. So many people come into Joplin day after day. And we just ask you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And you're coming today because you need some help, is that correct?
Yes, I do. I have an extremely large electric bill. It's over $500, and I'm trying to get some assistance. At this time in the season, there's not very much available for
electric.
Have
you tried a lot of places?
Yes, I have, and I've been striking out.
Everybody been just telling you they can't.
Yeah, so I always come to you, Rem Rice, because you always, your God, and you
all. We have some, we're asking people right now to pray. We have some really tremendous bills. We got ourselves close to $300,000 worth of bills.
Oh, my.
These inspectors have been coming down this building right now.
Oh, Jesus.
About $555,400 worth of repairs they want us to make.
Oh, I mean, Lord.
They were tacting inside, tacting outside. That all started after they put these barricades all up and down the sidewalks here.
I see.
So we need people really, really praying for us. But in the middle of all that need, we still are trying to help people whose utilities are shut off, about to be shut off, if we got money in our needy fund. And right now, we need people to really help us to really get involved at this time. We need people to really help, to people to share, to people to let the power of the resurrection work in their life and through their life. Do you know that Jesus loves you?
Yes, Jesus does.
How
Jesus
does that message of the resurrection make a difference in your life?
It makes it all that much difference, because you cannot live without Him. He controls it all. And unless you have faith in Him and do what His word is, you won't be blessed.
Yeah, you know, the message of the resurrection is a message that we just continue to let Christ's light and love flow through us. So many people coming to us in need day after day, and we're trying to help them, but I need your help right now. I need you to go to those phones and call. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Please share the love of Jesus at this time. You can give online at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. And just let your light shine. Let the message of the resurrection work in you and through you right now. and get directly involved as we're trying to continue to be there when people are hurting. Yes, there are so many people come to us at New Life Evangelistic Center. There's so many great needs. And so many of the people that are homeless continue to pray for us here and share with us. As many of you know, we've been going through a series of hearings at City Hall. Yes, we've tried to make application to get the necessary permits here, but at the same time, we're asking you just to let Christ's light and love flow through you. You've been to these hearings. We've been appealing this decision by this building commissioner that says we're located across from the school. We can't get permits for a shelter, but they put that school here after we've been here almost 40 years. So, I mean, and we just see the ongoing bigotry and hostility trying to stop us from sheltering the homeless at 1411 Locust, it seems like.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. You call it bigotry. I call it just oppression. It's oppressing the homeless population. I don't think the city's been very fair and very concerning on how it deals with the homeless. And I thank God for you all being here, regardless to whatever differences you may have with the community. You have, you're here and your doors are open while other doors are not open. You have services available while other places don't have services available at hours that people may still be in need. I know that it's important for this institution to stay available for people who have needs.
Because you came in your time of need.
I came in my time of need. I'm going to support the organization and the ministry by attending the hearing at City Hall, because I think that's important. They need to hear from people who have been through this, who have found some success after this. It's not all about enabling people and keeping people in one condition. It's about helping people to get to their next step in life. And I thank you for that.
And I thank God for all of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center, making it possible for us to help people that are hurting, people that are homeless, whether it's at 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, whether it's in Potosi, Columbia, all these other locations. I thank God for those of you that are sharing. We need the community to really pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. You know, we saw back in fall of 2012 where they put barricades around the building.
Okay? I remember that.
And then in 2013, inspectors started coming in here,
yes,
like locusts, okay? Mm-hmm. And they say, you got to fix this, that, and the other. Now they want us to spend $555,400 just to make repairs inside of here, okay? Mm-hmm. And then they're attacking on the outside of here. So it just seems like the battle just keeps going on and on and on. But God is there, and we're trusting Him, and we're still here. They would have shut us down a long time ago. People have been praying for us and helping, you know?
Yeah, I thank God for that. And also, it's not so much an attack on New Life. It's an attack on the population. And I think New Life has been attacked because it advocates for this population of people that they want gone. They remove benches out of the near parks near this area, and I just find that a travesty. And I speak to people and I speak to neighbors around, and not all the neighbors around here are that's not the sentiment that they want to express.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that you've given people opportunity to have an avenue to be able to express opposition to doing things that are cruel. I think it's cruel to knock down trees that have been there 10 to 20 years just because a homeless person has been known to take refuge up under that tree for shade. And so all of those are just examples.
And then next, the homeless used to be in the parks next door. Now they run the homeless out of there, and they have the dogs run in there.
They took the homeless out of there, and I speak to people. I have spoken to a guy yesterday, and we're an officer, and he was running some people out just as early as yesterday. And he said, well, these people and these lofts over here, they pay for this park now.
Well, that's a city park.
And it's a city park, and I'm wondering how in the world do a city park go from being a city park open for the public to having it exclusively used for just a small population of the citizenship.
That's a misuse of police power, but they know the people are powerless. They don't have the money to sue them. They know that the Justice Department would side with a homeless if they do it.
That's right.
But we see these officers just supporting. They become security guards for rich folks right now, not representing all the people, it seems like.
I would totally agree with that, and something has to be done. This hearing is a part of something being done. We need favor with this hearing so that this institution can stay available for people. I think with this battle here, some other battles can be won outside of these doors that's around this area in downtown.
Well,
the answer ain't running people off. The answer is giving them proper care and concern, and I think you are part of being part of that care and concern.
And thank you all for supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center so we can help hurting people. But again, we receive no city, state, federal dollars, United Way dollars. It's caring people that love Jesus that are sharing with this work, making it possible. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Please let the light and love of Jesus flow through you now. We need to hear from each one of you. The hour is late. The situation is critical. And I need you to get involved and do it right now.